Good morning everyone. So today our first program will be write a program to display a numeric value. Okay, so let's go. So when you come over here, let's select in the front panel. Over here you right click, you will get the controls, you go to numeric, and over here you place the take this numeric control and drag it down over here. So see, when we have developed this one in interface, user interface, we have got a block diagram in the block palette in the block diagram also. Similarly, what we want to do, we want to see what number we will be giving input. Okay, so let's take this numeric indicator and again put it over here. So the first numeric one is our input, so we will write it down as input, and the second one is for looking into the output, so we will be putting it as output. Now if you compare these two, in the input and the output, in the input the background is white and you are able to put in any values. Okay, further you are having an incremental and decremental stuff, whereas in output, even if you want to change over here, see, it is changing. Okay, but we will see when we run this, it will not be we will not be able to change, and it will only display what we have given the input. Now if you come to the block diagram, if you see, now if you run this one program, see, there is nothing which is happening. This is the run button. If you click this one, nothing is happening. You can also do this by run the program by clicking Control R. Okay, so now we have given only one signal. When we just click the this run Control R or this run button, it only executes the program once. Okay, but if you see, there has been no change. Why? Because if you come in the block diagram, if you see the output of the input control, it is in no way connected to the input of the indicator. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to give some write some program which will help in the transfer of the data from the input to the output panel. Now let's click over here. So when you see, when I am bringing this into the output of the input panel, it changes just like a wiring cable. So this means we need to connect in some terminals. This tool helps us in connecting the terminals. Okay, so I will just close this. Yeah, so now if you see, now it has been connected. Now if I run the program, this run button in the front panel and the run button in the block diagram, they perform the same function. You can use either of this or you can press Control R. Okay, now if you see, when I have run this, our whatever input I have given in the over here in the front panel, 25, it has been generated in the output. Say I now change it to 30, run it, see, the output is 30. Okay, now this is for a single run. If you want to run it multiple times, then we can use this button over here, run continuously. This is also present over here, right in the block diagram. So let's click over here. Now as you change, see, in a real time, since the program is continuously running, as we are changing these values in the front panel, the values are being changed in the indicator of the front panel. Okay, thank you very much. So we have created a first program over here, right? So thank you very much.